Hi guys, it's Wade here. I just wanted to give you a quick look at how I have to operate at home because I don't have a real shack and I only have low power conditions on my license, which doesn't worry me. I liked having lots of fun. So let me spin around here. So yes, I lay on the floor. I've got my 817. I've got my auto tuner, the Z817 from LDG. Got my tablet for logging, which I'm going to do a really good review on VK Portalog in the coming days. I actually have my new Soda Beams filter, which I believe is the kit version of the one from Germany. I can't remember what that organization's called. Got a coffee, because you got to stay hydrated while chasing. And then I've just got some coax running outside. Hey guys, I just wanted to give you a bit of an overview of VK Portalogger. It's a great bit of software available on Android. I use it on a really cheap little tablet, Lenovo tablet. I think it cost me about $90 from Office Works here in Australia. But just looking at the screen, I'll go back to the setup screen. When you load VK Portalogger, it gives you what options are preloaded. So as you can see here, I've got my call sign loaded, my name, my what radio I'm using. All this stuff is so it exports to my log, what I'm actually doing. So in this case, I'm operating from my QTH. I don't have a Soda reference. It's not a Parks activation. I don't have a reference. I don't have Shires, which is what we another type of activation we do here in Australia. Where I want it to measure my location from, the Canberra. I've used some user-defined fields, I'll show you, and a couple of other options here. So if I needed to change them like I was actually up on a summit, just hit change and go through and set up the details through here. Example, if I needed to change my call sign to say I was operating somewhere else, or if it was a Parks activation, or if it was a Soda, so if I did a Soda, and then what's my summit reference? I could just enter it all there, etc. In this case, I'm just working from home. And that'll do for that. So then back on the logging screen. So let's have a bit of a look here at the logging screen. You can preset some stuff. So the call sign, I really like. So I just worked Ian before, VK1DI. All I'd have to do if I heard his call over the radio, I've got some hot keys set up here. So VK1DI. Now, because I've worked him before, his details are preloaded. I know his name. I can add the frequency we've been working. I'm using 5 watts. I can enter our signal report. And interestingly, if you scroll up, there's other details. So if I was to show you Ian's one from before, Ian's details are all there. We both got a 5.8. I've got his park details, the frequency, and everything like that. The other benefit is, all the spots come filtering through. So if I was able, so this is a CW contact that's just been loaded through Parks and Peaks. You can pre-fill. So I've already worked Gerard once today, but if I was to hit his spot, it pre-fills all his details here into the log screen. I'll clear them. And so there's the Soda Watch and the Parks and Peaks. And it just keeps filling down the log for you. And if you wanted to know how many summit to summits, how many park to parks, how many etc., you just hit summary. In this case, I haven't worked any summits today. I've worked two WWFF guys, so the parks guys. I've done 2 contacts in total. Days, I'll have this down like way down here.
But in a couple of my videos, you've seen me log one-handed. So a classic example is, say, VK3, golf, golf, golf. Mick, he always comes up on contacts. So if it was a 5-9, 5-9, blah, 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 save, bang. Details logged. And then I'll show you what it looks like when you export it. So how I export all of my logs is I use Dropbox straight from my tablet to my laptop upstairs. So I just hit add a file. And in the VK Portalogger folder, there's all the folders from the different dates that you've been activating or chasing anytime you've made a log. Today being Christmas Eve, being the 24th. So I have a CSV file, which is a spreadsheet file. And I also have the ADI that I can directly import straight into my logging software. So if I was to go back and find one of the dates that I was also activating. So this is the date I was activating. So you'll see here that I've got multiple different files. The ADI is the straight up export one. This one here. This is one I can send off to Parks and Peaks. This stuff here I can send straight off into Activator and Chaser. I can upload straight up into SODA data. And then there's one there for my records, which is fully CSV, straight into a spreadsheet. So for me, this is the best way I find to log and to manage my contacts on summits. I always keep a pencil and paper should I need to go manual. Foxtrot Whiskey Bravo Delta.
G'day there, Wade, VK1, Fox Whiskey Bravo Delta. I think I've already worked you on this park as well, haven't I?
QSL Gerard. I'm actually just making a video regarding VK Portalogger, and I have the camera on, and I'm just showing how easy it is to log one-handed. Over.
Oh, you're logging one-handed. Very good. Hold the microphone in one hand and hold the log in the other. Spots of rain here, but it's not stopped. It's not quite so urgent that I get off the air. In fact, I think the rain on the wing trip's already evaporated. How little there was there. I'm down near Mossvale there, Wade, activating the park, Tessel Hoskins Nature Reserve, Abbott.
QSL, and you're a beautiful, crisp 5858, which is holding steady from our previous contact. Over.
Yeah, thanks, Wade. Yeah, 5 and 7 here, 57. Operating from a car with 80 watts output.
Wow, okay, I'm only using 5, over.
Yeah, QSL, it's good signal for 5 watts, it was good conditions just now. We've been able to work into VK1 on 20 metres, which is pretty rare.
Oh, QSL, no worries, and I knew 1MA was up on Kosciuszko, but I couldn't work him before he went QRT. Anyway, I won't hold you because I know you're on your way down the coast, I believe, for Christmas. Anyway, thanks for coming back and holding on your last contact, Gerard. I'll upload the video shortly, but I really wanted to make the video to show people how easy it is, and I know you're a user as well, over.
Christmas.
7-3 to you too. Have a great Christmas and I'll work you in the new year. VK2 India Oscar Portable, VK1 Foxtrot Whiskey Bravo Delta. Clear. So guys, that's been a quick look at VK Portalogger, the software I use on my Android tablet to allow me to log, export, manage all my contacts when I'm on summits. One thing I really, really like is the management of spots and things like that. I can spot from inside the app. I can also chase from inside the app. And also the fact that it pulls up the operator's name, I really, really appreciate that. I like to come back and, oh, VK3, GGG. Oh, good. How you going, Mick? Yeah, Wade here. We haven't worked for ages, but it's great to catch up with you. VK1DI, oh, Ian, how are you going? Blah, 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 etc. Stuff like that. I really, really appreciate that. And I think it's really personable when we're trying to build a community across the radio. If you have any questions, don't forget to put them down below and like, comment, and subscribe on the channel. There's a heap of soda stuff and there's also a heap of diving stuff. So there'll be something hopefully that interests you. I really like to thank you for watching the video today. Cheers.